Are we? Ravenia.
My father always told me, I wandered the red.
Take your time looking about. Plenty of wonderful books to stoke a curious mind like yours.
Welcome, everyone. I see you've already met some of the many beasts we study in this class. Though be advised, none of these creatures should be taken lightly. They are all in their own way dangerous, especially if one does not know how to handle them properly. Now, it seems many of you are out of practice. Let's take some time to review the basics of how to care for a beast, shall we? Miss Sweeting, would you please assist our new student with the lesson today?
Yes, Professor Howen. Hello, I'm Poppy, Poppy Sweeting. Don't worry about Professor Howen's speech. She over-exaggerates sometimes. All the beasts in class are perfectly safe. Oh!
Miss Sweeting, pay attention, please. The tongue of a Puffskin can be a slippery devil.
Yes, Professor. Here, you can practice on Gerald. Just keep an eye out for his tongue. You can use my brush. Just be gentle. Oh, and think pleasant thoughts. I like to think it enriches his experience. That's lovely. I'm sure he feels much better. I think he might be hungry. Would you mind giving him some beast feed? What do you suppose the pellets taste like to Gerald? Pudding, I like to think. I think we can safely say that Gerald likes you.
That's good news. He seems very nice.
He is. Kindness is one of his best qualities, right after ambition. And cleanliness.
Good work, everyone. Now, let's make our way to the pens and select another beast. And please, do be careful as you feed and groom them. Miss Sweeting, why don't you show our new student to the Neasels in the farthest pen?
This way. The Neasels are over here.
Oh, couple of Neasel whiskers ought to get me a few canuts at least. Enough to buy something from Honeydukes. Stupid thing.
What in Merlin's name are you doing?
Tuss, peculiar Poppy. Worried about a worthless little rodent.
Her name is Persephone!
Her name is Persephone!
That's really not funny.
Let's go.
Those two don't belong anywhere near this class. Poachers in training. Persephone was onto them instantly. Thank you for your help. Let's carry on.
What would you like me to do next, Professor?
Assist Miss Sweeting at the Neasel enclosure. She will need help brushing and feeding them. You will find it is similar to your work with the Puffskins.
The Neasels really took to you. They know a good egg when they see one. As do I.
It appears our time has come to an end. Please close the pens and see yourselves out. Now, where is our new student? Ah, there you are. I would like a moment, please.
Hello, Professor. You wanted to speak with me?
I did. How did you find your first beast's lesson?
It was wonderful. I believe I'm really going to enjoy this class.
Good. You seem to understand that when beasts are properly controlled, they can play a vital role in our lives. Some provide us with magically imbued materials, if cared for correctly, which does not include torturing them for whiskers. Well done, by the way. Probably best to let me handle it next time.
Yes, Professor.
They're nearly as bad as the savagers in Rookwood's poacher pack. Sadly, we're the ones who suffer, stumbling over dead beasts. Terrible waste of resources.
Surely the poachers can be brought to justice by someone. The Ministry, perhaps.
An optimistic idea. Now, why don't we focus on more immediate matters that we can control? Professor Weasley has asked that I prepare some assignments designed to help you catch up to the other fifth years. Be on the lookout for my owl. Meanwhile, I also encourage you to study as many beasts as you can on your own time.
Psst. Psst. Over here.
Did you need something, Poppy?
Thank you again for saying something to those brutes so that I didn't have to. You were an augury at noon in the desert.
I certainly hope that's a good thing.
It's something my gran and I say. It means that something or someone is a welcome surprise. At least, that's what we decided it meant.
I couldn't stand there and watch them harm the poor thing.
We're of a similar mind. Actually, in light of that, there's someone I'd like you to meet in the forest.
You've intrigued me. Very well, lead the way.
I'd hoped I would. I wouldn't take just anyone there. In fact, you're the first.
Really? Well, thank you, I think.
As I said, we think alike. Pleasant surprise. Quite the weather we're having. Don't you think?
Poppy, where are you taking me?
It really is much better than I just showed you. Don't worry, we're nearly there. It's just ahead. Stand back. Isn't she just magnificent? Go on, introduce yourself to her. But be careful. You must always show hippogriffs the proper courtesy before you approach them. Take to someone this quickly. You can feed and brush her if you'd like. I come and check on her every once in a while. Bring her pasties, tell her what's going on in the castle. You wouldn't know from looking at her, but she's a dreadful busybody. So, what did you think of Highwing?
I thought she was brilliant. Can't believe you introduced me to her.
I suspected you two might get along.
Are you the reason students have been seeing hippogriffs flying above the Forbidden Forest?
Perhaps. Did you know that once you earn a hippogriff's trust, they'll always be there for you? I've seen it firsthand with her.
How exactly did you and Highwing cross paths?
It's a longer story, but I rescued her from poachers a few years back. Got her to safety and, well, she was fine until recently. You may have noticed that poachers are something of a problem in the area, so I worry they could get her again. And I might not be there next time.
Professor Howard mentioned the poachers as well. She seemed to imply that we couldn't rely on the Ministry to help.
I don't often agree with Professor Howen, but on that, I fear she's right. The poachers' influence is growing. I see them every day in the village, lingering, talking to people. They're up to something. I'm just not sure what.
That does seem strange. Sounds as if they're planning something.
Exactly. I think I'm going to look into it. Find out what's going on, what they're doing.
I think that's a fine idea. Information is power.
And the more I know, the better I can keep Highwing safe.
You seem undeterred. Will you let me know what you find out?
Oh, very well. I will. I should be going, but we'll speak again soon, I hope. I hate to see a creature get put down.
I'm told that last Clementine had you...
Greetings. Please, take your time looking about.
You've a good head for business, haven't you? You'll need to save up a bit more for that, I'm afraid. No one can say I don't keep a stacked shelf. Hello, be with you in a bit. Oh, it's you! What a pleasant surprise. Now, you let me know if there's anything else I can help you with. No one can say I don't keep a stacked shelf. You're back. Nice to see you again.
Let's look at what we have, shall we? Let me know if there's anything else I can do to help.
We have everything a young student might need when it comes to potions. Have a good look around. What can I do for you today? I hope to see you again. Farewell for now.
You're back. Nice to see you again.
I don't cast the odd cleaning spell.
It'll be done with magic.
Here you found it. Come on in. Healing potions are a speciality here, should you need any.
That last Clement. Greetings. Please take your time looking about. Now, you let me know if there's anything else I can help you with. No one can say I don't keep a stacked shelf. Thank you.
Helios.